farming others, it's always good to see you and to have you around. So in this video, we are going to talk exclusively on lighting, okay? In order to raise broilers successfully, you have to understand how the lighting fits into their growth and how it affects their development. Lighting is a very big deal. From the hours that the lights are on to the intensity of the light, every bit matters. You have to provide them with the right amount of light. You have to provide them with the right hours of light. For example, someone might not see the need to change bulbs or to have different light intensities. But this is a very important factor because it affects the development of the birds. Okay? If you have lamps that can provide you with different intensities, that is very, very important. And I recommend that you use those. Why? When chicks first arrive at the farm, they need time to adapt to the environment. They need some discovery time. They need to see properly in order to get access to the feed and to the water. So you are providing them with full intensity of the light, and it will factor into how they quickly adapt to the environment. They can easily find the feed, they can easily get to the water. At that first day, the lighting intensity is very important. You want to keep it maximum so that they are able to find their ways around. Now, after the first week, they have adapted to the environment already. You have to be careful now with the lighting. Lighting intensity has to be stepped up. And by the way, from day zero or day one, you should give your birds some sleep time. For instance, what I do here in the farm is the programming of the system allows birds from day one or day zero to 40 and when they will leave the farm to rest 5 hours a day. The birds have a sleep time from 11 p.m. until 4 a.m. in the morning. If you have the capacity to program them, it's very important. If you cannot, I recommend you get different lamps and you manage to change the intensities so that your flock will develop properly. Now, from the 8th day, that is after their first week on the farm, what I do is the intensity is dropped from 100 to 80. Now, the reason is this. When chicks feed continuously under intense lighting, they are going to put up excessive weight, which could foolishly be seen as a bonus, but it is very disastrous in the sense that the organs are going to put on a lot more weight than they can accommodate. And if your lighting is not properly managed to rhyme with their growth rate, you're gonna have a lot of sudden deaths, okay? You will suffer from what is referred to as sudden death syndrome. You're gonna have a lot of birds that will be dropping dead without any prior warning, without any cause. Sudden, you just find it's gone. You just find it's gone. And depending on whether you realize what is happening or not, you might just end up losing a lot of birds if you don't come to the realization that your lighting is the main contributing factor to that excessive weight gain. So you want to manage their growth. You want to make sure that they put on the weight, but at a rate that is normal for their development and growth. You don't want to push them to feed too much and put on excessive weight. They are going to suffer from overweight. It doesn't only happen to humans, it happens also with the chicks. If you give them too much, they are going to have overweight, and they will have this overweight, and the skeletal system is not yet developed enough to bear this weight. So please, you have to regulate lighting. Very, very important. You have to keep an eye on it in order to save the flock and to make sure that they are developing appropriately. What we do is from the 8th day, that is after the first week, the lighting intensity is stepped down, from 100% to 80% we dim the lamp. Actually, in this band where I'm going now in this video, there are 8 days old today, and the lighting has been dimmed. If you look at what we had on the first 7 days, it's totally different from this. When the birds get to 3 weeks, we step again down the lighting from 80% intensity to 60%. At that intensity, they can stay properly, still find their way to the feed, to the water, and their feet, and there is not a lot of activity in the band. The reason why we limit this activity is because it's going to affect the breast quality of the chickens. It affects their development. Okay? If they get too violent at this later stages, when they are putting up a lot of weight, it's also destructive if you allow that. What happens after the first week is that even though we step down the intensity of lighting, the ventilation gives some light into the band, like you see in this band. The lamp's intensities have been dropped to 80%, but the light is still very appropriate. The inlets are still opening and closing, providing some light as they do ventilate the band. So this is how you ought to manage lighting. It's an important component, because if not, you're going to suffer what I just described as sudden death syndrome. You will have a lot of birds that look very healthy, so heavy, suddenly dropping dead as much as possible. And it's a very bad thing to happen, knowing fully well that this could be resolved with simple lighting and providing them with the appropriate light necessary. As regard to the sleep, it's very important as living organisms that we all have some time to rest. This is why a sleep period is devoted for the chicks and for the birds when they get older. There is a period of 5 hours that the birds rest. There is no feeding activity, there's no drinking. The lights slowly turn off automatically from 11 p.m. mimicking the natural sunset system. So it takes actually 30 minutes for these lights to go off so that they can rest. So from 10:30 to 11 p.m. these lights are dimming slowly. It mimics the sunset process, the same way it happens in the natural environment. This is how the programming is done. So by 11 p.m. the birds are all resting. By 4 a.m. in the morning, they start coming on slowly, and it takes another 30 minutes for them to fully come to their appropriate intensities. So I provide the birds on the farm in every band with 3 stages of intensities. For the first week, from 0 to 7 days, they have full light intensities, that is 100% intensity, and they have 5 hours of sleep, that's automatic as well. And from the 8th day, that is when we begin the second week, the lighting intensity is dropped for the reasons I just mentioned. It's dropped to 80%, so we dim them. From 3 weeks, again, we turn it down a little bit, just to enable them to develop naturally. We don't want to push them to develop too fast. If not, you will pay the consequences in the increase of mortality. Now, anything you do that is way too much for them, they're gonna throw it back at you. So by the 3rd week, what they need is not bombarding them with feed. What they need is some feed, some water, some rest. Like this, some exercise, some feed, some water, some rest. So again, you put the light intensity to the level that will support the need of that particular stage. So we drop it again from 80 down to 60 at 3 weeks. And from these 3 weeks, we keep it at 60 until they are out. When we do the harvesting, as I mentioned again, the lights are kept off just to ensure that birds are properly taken care of during their growth period and even when they are taken out of the farm. It's very, very important. It's gonna save you a lot. So, let me know if this video is important, if you found the information resourceful or not. Let me know if you're a farmer, what you're doing with your lighting. If you provide one light intensity from start to finish, what your experience is, it's very important. It's an interactive video. Let's learn together, and I'll see you in the other videos as well. Don't forget to check out my other videos. They have a lot of information on different aspects. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't, so that you never miss a video. I put up content on poultry production, farming in general. I can also answer lots of questions on that. If you're interested in farming,